Before diving into the circuit analysis, let's make a few assumptions. First, inductors L1 and L2 are large enough to have a high inductive reactance at the desired frequency. So the inductors only feed DC current to the collector of the transistors, while isolating the power supply from the RF spectrum. Second, we analyze this multi-stage amplifier at the moderate frequencies. Third, RO, the resistance between the collector and emitter, is very large. Therefore, with these assumptions, all inductors will be open and all capacitors will be short circuit for the small signal analysis, and all inductors will be short circuit and all capacitors will be open for the DC analysis. As you can see here, both transistors have a similar current gain beta and they are fed from 68 kilo ohm resistors. So for both transistors, the base current can be calculated by subtracting the base emitter junction voltage from the 5 volt power supply and divided by the base resistor RB. The collector current can be obtained by multiplying beta by the base current. Here, the resistor RAE is the dynamic resistance looking from the emitter terminal, and the RPi is the dynamic resistance of the base emitter diode looking from the base terminal. This small signal model is the AC equivalent of the above circuit. Both inductors L1 and L2 are removed from the small signal model because they have a very high impedance at the desired frequency. And the transistor current gain is modeled with a dependent current source placed between collector and emitter. The dynamic resistance RPi is placed between the base and emitter. RO, the collector emitter resistance, is ignored in this small signal model because it is assumed to be very large compared to the load and RPi. By the way, if you like what you are watching, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Now back to the video. To determine the voltage gain VAO to VAI for this multi-stage amplifier, we try to find the voltage gain for each stage separately and then calculate the amplifier overall voltage gain. The negative signs here are the 180 degree phase shift for the common emitter configuration. To determine voltage gain for each stage, the approach I usually take for common emitter and common base configurations is to find the ratio of equivalent resistance at the collector node to the equivalent resistance at the emitter terminal. So it means for the first stage, the voltage gain VAO1 to VAI will be the biasing resistor RAB2 in parallel with the resistance seen from the base of Q2, which is RPi2, and dividing it by the RAE1, which is the emitter dynamic resistance of Q1. For the second stage, the voltage gain VAO to VAO1 will be the ratio of the load resistance to the emitter dynamic resistance of Q2. Therefore, the overall voltage gain will be multiplying the voltage gain of the stage 1 by gain of stage 2. And here is the voltage gain in dB. The input resistance of the amplifier is the resistor RAB1 in parallel with the RPi1. And the output resistance seen from the load resistor will be the collector emitter resistance RO in parallel with the inductive reactance of L2, which both assume to be very high. I have other videos in reviewing BJT small signal, which I will put the links under the video description.